A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 9th September, on the front page you have Trump calls off secret talks with Taliban. So US President Donald Trump has criticized bomb attack in Kabul, and Taliban has been negotiated with, and at the same time Taliban is also conducting such strikes, terror attacks in Afghanistan. So that is why now US President has called off secret talks with Taliban. Already the Afghan President Ashraf Ghani had been critical of these talks because the Afghan government was not involved. US is keen to leave Afghanistan, to remove its troops from Afghanistan, not completely. It has been stated earlier too that around 5,000 troops would, all no soldiers would remain on in Afghanistan, but they want to reduce their presence to minimum. So that is why US is keen on a peace deal with Afghanistan, with Taliban. So Taliban is was the government in power earlier, and it has been conducting such terror attacks for long. Even after 11 years of the Afghan war, terror attacks continue. So now the talks have been called off. Then here you have Chandrayaan 2 orbiter spots lander on moon. So this is development here in Chandrayaan 2. The ISRO chief Sivan has confirmed hard landing of the module. So Vikram was supposed to make a soft landing, the lander was supposed to make a soft landing, but it must have been a hard landing, has been confirmed now by ISRO. The orbiter has spotted the lander. Then below you have, we won't dilute Article 371. Shah ensures northeastern states. So Home Minister Amit Shah has ensured northeastern states that though Article 370 of the Constitution, which provided special status to Jammu and Kashmir, has been revoked, Article 371 providing special provisions for northeastern states would not be affected, would not be diluted. So this assurance has been given. Then on page 5 you have MP's happiness department to open time bank. So this is regarding Madhya Pradesh. You should know that Madhya Pradesh government has a happiness department established, and now this happiness department plans to set up a time bank. So time bank means it will be using time as units of time as a currency. So reciprocal service exchange can be done through it as time as a currency. So, time can be exchanged to learn a new skill without the need for any paper money. So, an example is given here, like whenever a bank member needs a service or wants to acquire a skill, say gardening or playing a guitar, she could exchange a credit worth an hour with another member knowing the skill. On page 8, you have road bypassing Bandipur inspected after Supreme Court directive. So Supreme Court is looking into the night traffic ban on this national highway in which passes through Bandipur Tiger Reserve. So this is in Karnataka. So Supreme Court had directed the center to respond to its suggestion on developing an alternative route in this case pertaining to the ban on night traffic through Bandipur Reserve. So it is seeking response now and inspecting what developments have taken place. Here you can see that this is a 36 kilometer detour alternative route which is required to enforce this ban, and this ban is on National Highway 212, and under the new numbering it is called National Highway 766. So you should know about this highway, and you should know the length of the highway is 272 kilometer, and 34.6 kilometer of this passes through the Bandipur Tiger Reserve and the National Park. So it cuts through even 19.7 kilometer of the core zone of Bandipur and 4.5 kilometer of its buffer zone. So night traffic ban has been introduced following a directive from Mysuru Deputy Commissioner in 2009 to provide wild animals a reprieve from vehicle movement. So this ban is at night, that is 9 p.m. to 6 a.m. But this ban has been challenged in High Court of Karnataka, from which upheld the decision of Mysuru Deputy Commissioner, and then the matter went to the Supreme Court. Supreme Court has also upheld the ban, and it is asking the central government to look for alternative routes. On page 9, you have study sheds more light on killing of American by sentinels. So this was an incident which took place in Andaman and Nicobar Islands on the North Sentinel Island, where an American national, John Allen Shaw, was killed by the Sentinelese tribe here. It has been around 9 months ago now, in 2018. And now we can see a study has been undertaken. A recent survey by Anthropological Survey of India says preservation of Chow's diary is crucial as it seeks to throw more light on the incident. So the diary gives more information on what happened, you know, in this North Sentinel Island, which resulted in his death. Then this is Nilgiri's Thar population up by 27% in 3 years. So the Nilgiri Thar has its population increased by around 27% in 3 years, and this is detailed out here. Then below you have, amid acute poverty, Saharia children battle malnutrition. So this is regarding the particularly vulnerable tribal community. It's called PVTG, particularly vulnerable tribal group, Saharias. So here the instances of premature pregnancies and TB instances are also high among children, and this has resulted in many malnutrition deaths also amongst this community, the Saharia community. One important point which is highlighted here about this tribal community is that they have delayed breastfeeding. So this delayed breastfeeding, they say that the first milk is impure. So it is extracted from breast after 9 long months, so that is why it is not given. So 3 days after being delivered, you know, they are not being fed. So they are fed on jaggery syrup or honey. So this is one important point and one important aspect which results in malnutrition amongst children and vulnerability. So this is a point to be highlighted, and education and, you know, behavioral change is required here, because breastfeeding is the key and initial milk is gives immunity to the children, which is not fed by this community. On the editorial page, the first editorial is "So close yet so far." So this is regarding Chandrayaan 2. It says Chandrayaan 2 might have failed in an objective, but the mission itself is not a failure. So appreciations have poured in for the Chandrayaan 2 mission. We have seen though Vikram lander failed to make a soft landing. And the second editorial, "Italy afloat." So this is regarding the far right in the political spectrum. The rise of the far right in the political spectrum presently has been halted, but this editorial says that this halt and this respite might be temporary. So an unlikely ruling coalition has been formed in Italy, of the anti-establishment five-star movement and the center-left Democratic Party. So, you know, it seems free of the many unwieldy elements of the previous government. But then how long they would be able to hold power is also a question. And the lead article is "Throttled at the Grassroots." So this is regarding how local governments remain hamstrung and ineffective. They are mere agents to do the bidding of the higher level government. So how democratic decentralization is barely alive now in India is highlighted in this article, which is important. And this is "Trump, Europe and the Iran effect." So this is regarding the Iran crisis. The Iran has breached the nuclear deal provisions of which USA has opted out. So it says the Iran crisis reflects the strains between US and Europe over the US president's maximalist political approaches. So European countries are also signatories to the Iran nuclear deal, but then European countries could not stand against the US warnings of sanctions. And US President Donald Trump has this maximalist political approach, means he puts maximum pressure to gain outcome. No, it has not always worked. Like, Iran has also breached the nuclear deal, which is not good for the world. Then on the op-ed page, you have an arbitrary transfer, a graceful resignation. So this is regarding Chief Justice Vijaya Tahiliramani. So she was transferred from the Madras High Court to Meghalaya High Court. So she said this amounts to humiliation of a judicial officer, this downgrading. And she has resigned. And this is a disturbing downward spiral. So this talks about how fundamental rights are being trampled, and in such times it is the duty of the press to stand with its citizens. And this is Saudis have lost the Yemen war. So the Yemen war, which was initiated by Saudi and the UAE along with its allies. So you can see the launch of the Yemen war in March 2015 has resulted in no credible goal being achieved. And the Shia Houthi rebels who were supposed to be defeated in this war still continue to hold sway in Yemen. So now Saudis have no credible ally on the ground and no effective strategy to turn around the war. So they have lost the Yemen war is what this article says. On page 13 you have, Vikram may not spring back to life, say space experts. So space experts believe that the moon lander may have crash landed on the lunar surface and the impact shock may have damaged the module beyond repair now. So this is the image which has been released from a live webcast by ISRO, which shows Vikram lander before it was supposed to land on the moon. Then below you have, Chinese trawlers in southern Indian Ocean worry India. So a huge increase in numbers of Chinese trawlers in southern Indian Ocean far from the Chinese coast have raised concerns. Chinese deep sea fishing trawlers have increased significantly here, which has raised concerns in the government and the security establishment. Then on international page you have, these are three continuation news. We have already discussed Taliban news on the front page in Afghanistan. Hong Kong protest news continue. And this is regarding Brexit and developments in UK, how Boris Johnson is facing setbacks when he wants to exit Britain, make Britain exit without a deal, and threatening to do so. But the British parliamentarians have passed a law which says that Brexit, no deal Brexit, cannot take place. You know, Brexit should be delayed in such a scenario till Jan 2020. Now another minister from Boris Johnson's as such government, a UK minister, quits. Then you have no important coverage on the business page, and the last page also has sports news. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Thank you.